Doctor, can you bring me something good?
Something good. Something good.
Hey y'all, it's your girl, and welcome back to my world. It's Vlogmas Day 6. How y'all doing? It's a brand new day, y'all. Give me a thumbs up for coming clutch on this consistency of vlogging back to back, because I be doing a hell of a good job, y'all. Yo, I look like somebody's mama. I be giving off mother vibes all. Like, even today, I'm like, I look like somebody's mom. Like, what's going on? But anyways, y'all, so I'm going to be talking about the time when I found out that Santa Claus was a phony. So I had to be about 4 or 5 years old. At the time, my mom and I lived 2-bedroom apartment with my friend from kindergarten and his mom. First of all, before we even get into the story time, give me a big thumbs up. Make sure you comment down below what is your favorite Christmas memory or any funny stories that you guys got from Christmas. Make sure you subscribe and turn on your post notifications to be notified every single time that I post, because I'll be coming back to back. Clap my hands for the consistency. Anyways, y'all, so I think this was Christmas Eve of 1990 something. Okay, so 96, 97. I was about 4 years old and I lived in a 2-bedroom apartment with my mom's friend and her son. And it was the night before Christmas, so you know we got scurried off to bed real early. But we were like, nah, like we want to see Santa, like let's stay up. So while my mom and his mom were out in the living room or the family room, whatever you guys call it, we were in his bedroom or my bedroom, like talking. And we were like, oh my god, like we gotta stay up, we gotta sneak out and see Santa. So they thought that we were sleeping. Little did they know that we were coming up with some scheme, some plans on how to sneak and see Santa Claus. Because, yo, we wanted to see this big, jolly old, fat man that's going to bring us presents. So we snuck. Okay, so it was the living room, and then it was a hall, and then it was our bedroom. So we came out our bedroom and went close to the wall to where, like, we could kind of see the living room, but, like, we were sneaking, so we were making sure that they couldn't see us. We could see you, but you can't see us. So we scurried out, and this had to be, like, real late, maybe, like, 11 o'clock as to when we thought Santa was coming. Mind y'all that our little butts are supposed to be in bed, sleeping, night, nurse. Yeah. So we were sneaking and tiptoeing, and I remember like we were literally crawling on the floor. to like sneak our heads around the corner to see like where our Christmas tree was and see that Santa was coming. Mind you, we lived in an apartment, so we were always questioning like, how does Santa get in our apartment if we don't have a chimney? And they were always saying, oh, he walks through the door. Like he could walk through walls and stuff, and we're like, yeah, okay. So we snuck out the bedroom and peeped our little heads around the corner and saw his mom and my mom putting presents underneath the Christmas tree. Yo, when I tell you that our hearts literally went womp womp womp, we went womp womp womp. Like, dead ass. Like, I was like, so where's, yo, I was literally so confused. I'm like, so where's Santa? Like, what's going on? Like, why are you doing this? This is Santa's job. Like, why are you putting presents under the tree? Shouldn't that be Santa's job? So after we snuck out and saw what was going on in the living room, we ran back to our bedroom and went back to sleep. Mind you, in the morning, y'all, bright and early in the morning, rise and shine, cock-a-doodle-doo. We got up, our parents were like still in the living room, and I think they were making us breakfast or like something. So we got out the bag and went to the living room to where the tree was, ready to open up gifts. Literally, they're like, oh, look what Santa bought you guys. Look what Santa bought you guys. Okay, I don't know how you guys were as kids, but I had a real smart mouth. Like, I would always come in quick with the responses. God, if I have a child. Oh, Lord. Because they say your kids are uterus too, so I could only imagine that a headache I am going to get with my child, okay? He or she's going to be real smart mouth. Next morning comes, and... you know, they're like, oh, look what Santa got you. Look what Santa got you. And I'm like, mommy, this ain't no Santa. Like, there was no Santa. She's like, yeah, look what Santa got you. Look what Santa got you. And we're like, no, that's not Santa. Yo, oh my God, I forgot to even tell you. We had put cookies out with milk for Santa Claus to eat and drink as a thank you for when he comes to, you know, deliver the gifts. You guys lied. There's no Santa. We saw you. Like, what are you talking about? No, these are the presents. I was like, no, we snuck out in the middle of the night, and we saw you guys putting this underneath. There is no Santa. There's no Santa. No, they tried so hard to convince us that they were Santa's helpers or something like that to help Santa Claus deliver the gifts because, you know, he's only one person. And I'm just like, you know what? Nah. So from ever since then, I felt like my whole childhood has changed. Like, my eyes have been open. I can see clearly now. The rain is gone. Like, I was so mad that my mom lied to me. I'm just like, mommy, you lied. Mommy, you lied. There was no Santa. There was no Santa. So, like, the other day now, when my stepdaughter, she's like, oh, Santa Claus is coming to my house, and blah, blah, blah. I kind of let it slip that there was no Santa Claus. So now, like, she tells me, like, what's up? Are we going to go see Santa? And I'm like, yeah, yeah. No, I was trying to tell her to be good so she could be on Santa's nice list. And she's like, Vista, you told me that there was no Santa. Do you see how that backfired on me? Like, in my face. So I'm like, no, I lied. I was joking. There's a Santa, so you better be nice and whatever, whatever. I kind of felt bad because I'm like, I don't want to take away her innocence or her, like, a big part of her childhood. But, yeah, guys. So that's kind of how I figured out that Santa wasn't real. I was about 4 or 5. And my life changed. Even though I continued to go take pictures with Santa Claus, I already knew the truth. I was just like, okay, this is just some man dressing up to be the children, but whatever. So, yeah, like, that's how I found out that Santa is fake. A phony. A con artist. And to be honest, like, the whole Santa Claus song, he sees you when you're sleeping, he knows when you're awake. Like, isn't that a little bit creepy, like a little child molesterish? Like, to me that's just weird. Like, why would you be watching me while I'm sleeping? Like, that's just real creepy. And then I tried to let my stepdaughter watch the Santa Claus movie, but she was just not interested. Like, she was just like, can we watch the Ace Family? Like, she's all up on the Ace Family. Like, she's a real YouTuber kid. Like, she loves YouTube just as much as I love YouTube. So, like, I gotta watch the amount of things that I say on my channel because she watches my channel. So, yeah. But I can't wait till Christmas and, like, get her the perfect gift. I gotta talk to my husband about this because all now, like, up to now, I haven't told him what I want to get her for Christmas. So, yeah, guys. So, that's how I figured out that Santa was a phony and a fake. I thank y'all for watching. Comment down below the age that you guys were when you found out that Santa wasn't real. If I just ruined it for you guys, I am so sorry. That was not my intention. But you gotta figure it out sometime. Alright, y'all, I'm out. I'm done talking. That's it for the video. I'm gone. I'm about to change out of this fancy fit and go put on like some sweats. And yeah. It's your girl, and I'm signing out of my world. Bye, guys.
It's with red and green underneath the Christmas tree. Hey, Santa, can you bring me?